Hi, I'm Ken Moore, and welcome to Local Matters. Well, one thing that matters locally is business. Business matters. So I've invited to be my guest today, Nathan Knottingham with the Chamber of Commerce. Thanks for being here, Nathan.
Thank you, Ken. It's a pleasure.
I'm very proud of our Chamber of Commerce. I'm a member, and I attend events, and I'm impressed with your ability to pull business community together and your wonderful staff. I think things are going really great there, so that's why I'm excited to have you here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for the compliment.
And I know you're busy and you're headed to Salem, is that right?
Yeah, have a meeting this afternoon.
What's going on down in Salem?
Just a board meeting for a community. There's a Center for Community Innovation. It's a nonprofit support group down there, and they are really reaching out to Yamhill County to bring support, training, and education to our nonprofits. And in the chamber, we have 51 nonprofit members, and so I go down there to help represent what's happening in McMinnville and try to bring up education to help support our nonprofits up here as well as our businesses.
Well, that's terrific.
Yeah.
Well, I hope that goes well. Maybe I'll have you back to hear about that.
We can talk about that too.
A lot of people would be interested in what they're going to say. Yeah. We have a lot of nonprofits.
We have a lot of nonprofits in Yamhill County.
And how about in the chamber? How many businesses have joined the chamber?
Today we are 410 members strong. And so that's 410 members. Represents roughly just over a third of the privately owned businesses in the greater McMinnville area that we can find.
And what percentage would you say is nonprofit, just roughly?
Well, 51, I believe there's 51 registered members that are nonprofits, so 20%?
Yeah.
Fifth?
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, great. We kind of jumped out into business there. I want to just touch personally.
Sure.
You've been in town for how long now?
I moved into town last November, a year and 3 months, November 11th of 2013. So I've been in town working since then, and then I moved my family up from Salem this past June on Father's Day weekend.
Happy Father's
Day. Yeah, I remember moving on a Father's Day weekend, so.
And how many kids?
I have two children. My son, Titus, is 5.5, and my daughter, Trinity, is 2.5. And I've been married for, it'll be 13 years this June, to my wife, Billy, whom I met in college.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah.
And a belated welcome to town.
Thank you.
It's great to have you here. Let me ask a little bit about what you've seen since you've been to town. What's happened with business? What growth has happened? Maybe you could let us in on some of the highlights.
Well, the first year of being in town is really getting to know the businesses and see who's here. But it has been encouraging. When I first got into town, I did 100 conversations. I tried to, and I still do this, I just go out and I try to meet with business owners and just say hi. How are you? What's happening in town? And that has led to some really good conversations that have both been positive about really good, prolific things happening in our community and some negative that we need to watch for. But we are seeing more businesses open up their doors. You know, we've had, I want to say, 5 new businesses join us in the last month. A photography business, Retta with Make Vacations Happen has joined up. McMinnville is kind of unique. We have 3 like vacation travel companies here in town. I mean, it's about the personal touch. Things that we love about McMinnville are still happening. We've been celebrating some anniversaries. Third Street Oil and Vinegar has had their anniversary. Kara's really excited. It's a great little shop down here on Third Street. And we're watching new businesses come in as well. We get a report, I pull a report from the city every year, or every month, I apologize, and we had somewhere in the neighborhood of $1.4 million put in for new contract permits through the city planning department. And we keep a look at that because that is exceptionally a really good pulse point for what's happening, and that's residential and commercial. So things are developing. We're watching landowners and leaseholders to reinvest in their area. We're watching business leases extend, renew, and also new ones come in. And there's more activities happening on 99, that old Twist tortilla shop that was
across
empty for a while.
Goodwill.
Yeah.
Okay. What's
going on there?
There's
some business going on there. Sure that I can say.
Oh, okay.
I know. So I'm not sure that it's full public, so I'm going to have to hold on that one.
All right. Well, we're excited to see what that is. They're really putting a new face on it.
They are. It's going to be a great little shop.
Great, great. So that's something about the growth. What opportunities do you see in the future? What does McMinnville offer? What are you What do you sell? What are your selling points when you talk to businesses about coming here? That's part of what you do.
It's a small part. You know, we partner with the McMinnville Economic Development Partnership. Mm. So MEDP, under the direction of Jody Christensen as the executive director, is a little over eight years old now. It's a joint partnership that the chamber started with the city and other companies as investors and partners. She is really ground floor getting out there and finding places and helping bring in some larger companies, mm-hmm. traded sector jobs, manufacturing, different growth companies that would probably take up larger plots of land at the McMinnville Industrial Promotions area, and working with MIP to do that and really build that area. The chamber is more about retaining. So we want to make sure we don't lose businesses. Retaining and helping grow.
So let's go over the mission of the chamber.
Yeah.
What are those?
Well, we want to be the premier resource for business development, for services, advocacy, and networking. It really is the four pillars of what we do. We promote our community. Mm-hmm. We provide education, awareness, and activation on political issues. We build networks and relationships. And we provide education to business owners in every way we can.
All right. So back to what's the strength of McMinnville? Yeah. Why do you see people coming here or growing here?
Well, why they come and then why they stay. And that's actually a really big piece, is why do they stay here? Mm-hmm. And we brag a lot about our school system. We have a lot to be proud of in our public and private school system here. Our public school system is record-setting. And Dr. Russell can give you just an amazing facts and figures that are proven over and over again.
Dr. Russell,
our superintendent of the McMinnville School District. And so we have an amazing public school system. We have a great private school system too. We have some fantastic private schools that give people choice. Choice draws different business owners. And when they can come into a town like this and know that their family is going to be well taken care of, they're more apt to land their business and invest in us and invest in our area, provide jobs, grow and develop. We also have a great parks and recreation system. I was in Arizona about a month ago at a chamber executive training session, and we were the topic of parks and recreation. What does that mean to a chamber of commerce who's helping to develop and grow and work in their economic development strategy? We can't underestimate the importance of green space and parks. Mm. And so to see this city and to talk to our parks director, Jay, and what they're doing to develop, they've just reassigned or finalized buying a new piece of property at a new park in an area that doesn't really have a lot of parks, what that's going to look like, it's exciting. And it brings a familial place so that those who are looking to come in and either develop a business or be recruited in by the hospital or a larger company, they have somewhere where they think their family, we're going to be safe, there's stuff to do, there's resources. So we brag on that a lot. And that
schools,
gets a lot
green
of people.
Space.
Schools, green space.
Hospital.
Hospital is a big one. Having a for-profit hospital, I don't know that a lot of people know that our Willamette Valley Medical Center is a for-profit hospital uh-huh. as a part of Capella Healthcare Systems. Because of that, they actually give back more to the community than I think a lot of people realize. Mm-hmm. So that might be a good interview for you, too, in the future.
Well, thank
That's
you.
That's a great one, yeah.
Good point. We want to know more about that.
Yeah, and so we have that. We have some big industry. Believe it or not, having a steel mill, having traded sector jobs, having manufacturing, having retail, having small businesses here, it's all part of a greater business ecosystem that just draws more business.
What are some concerns you have? What are some of the limitations? What are some of the things that maybe we can pay attention to develop a better business climate?
Some of the concerns will almost always come around transportation. Mm-hmm. Transportation and business is going to be a key component to stability and to growth. I don't want the audience listeners to hear and think that growth means we always want to grow, and with a unplanned and just try to go crazy. That's not the key. The mm-hmm. key is sustained, smart development that both builds a community and a business profession that pays for people. Coming with that, you know, the bypass, having that finished up soon, is going to help some of our businesses that are larger and do shipping. You know, I think of Freeland Wade. Mm-hmm. They ship polyurethane plastic coil. I mean, that's basically the, and tubing. Mm-hmm. They ship it worldwide. You look at the steel mill, Cascade Rolling Steel Mill. They have to ship too. If we can increase the time, so I'm sorry, decrease the time and increase the ease of which they can ship their goods to I-5 and get them dispersed, well, then they're able to stay. It costs them just a little bit less. So that provides jobs, and they're paying good wages. At the same time, we don't want to increase our transportation so much that we become a bedroom community and everybody uh-huh. drives away to Portland and uh-huh. our jobs kind of disappear. So it's a balancing act there. And I think the city governance and the county governance, they're looking at that. They've done a really fantastic job from an outsider coming in, relatively new, not being part of that whole planning process with Dave Hogberg, has been leading for 20 plus years. I'm excited about it though, yeah. because I think it brings the right blend of ease and flexibility mm-hmm. to keep our businesses here and to bring more people here with those jobs, and it's gonna look good.
We just have a few minutes left and we've saved the best for last. Well, okay. I don't wanna denigrate anything we've already said, but I'm excited about this last subject yeah. I wanna ask you about, and that's Lemonade Day. Can you tell us about that? Did you make that up? Has it been tried elsewhere? Give us the high points.
Let me give you the Lemonade Day is not my brainchild, so okay. I can't take any credit for that at all. The board, when I brought it to the board, the board of directors for the chamber, they got excited about it, and I see the same sparkle in the eyes of people when I talk to them about it, because it's a program in its seventh year, and it started down in Houston. It started with an entrepreneur had a daughter, and she said, "I want a turtle," and he said, "You have a lot of pets. If you earn the money for a turtle and can keep paying for the turtle, you can have a turtle." And he just kind of gave her a challenge, and she set up a lemonade stand. And it kind of clicked that we have a collective memory about lemonade stands in our culture.
Yes.
We have this idea that sunny, hot days, kids selling lemonade stands for 10 cents, 50 cents, however much they want to make.
Lemonade stands, you've bit off a goal that I just find staggering. Tell us about that.
So the program, it was developed, it's a 14-step program, so the kids will, the registration is open now at McMinnville.lemonadeday.org. People can go on there, register. It's free for the kids to get involved. Mm-hmm. There's a 14-step planned workbook that they're gonna go through. Its range is youth, so anywhere from kindergarten with mom and dad helping through sixth grade, and then teen is the seventh through high school. And the plan is they develop a business plan, the 14 steps, to have their own business that is a lemonade stand. Now they have to find their own investors, buy their own products, set their own price points, do their own marketing, brand themselves. And the goal we've set for this town is to have 400 lemonade stands.
Well, yes.
Let me say 400 students.
400 students.
Maybe
involved.
350 lemonade stands or
All
so.
Right.
Because not every business is sole proprietor. Sometimes yeah. there's teams and groups, and we tell the kids to do that. And so about 400 stands, and that's going to be May 2nd, the lemons drop, and we want to have 400 students being entrepreneurs on May 2nd, learning what it is to do business in a town like ours.
That's wonderful. I'm a sponsor of that, and I'm so excited to have that happen.
And we really appreciate that.
Yeah. We're going to set up in front of a bead store. Mm-hmm. John Regal and I are kind of co-sponsoring a stand.
That's awesome.
And you're going to have 350 stands around town.
We're planning on that. You know, the kids on the block, we took it to them as okay. well and said, "Hey, would this be a benefit?" And they were ecstatic about it because okay. it's great melding of our school system. And then because the school is teaching these kids fantastic skills.
Nathan, I'm going to have to stop you.
Oh, no. Okay.
We're going to, they'll be rolling into the credits as we keep talking. So I'm just going to say thank you very much.
No problem.
And Ken Moore with Local Matters. Thank you, Nathan, for being here.
Thank you.
And join us again for Local Matters.